Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nicole Huseman and thank you so much for clicking on this video. Today I'm going to be telling you my New Year's resolutions, my New Year's intentions, and a couple New Year's goals I have. So I'm really excited to share with you what I have coming up this year, kind of envision a better 2021 than we had 2020, although who knows. So let's get into that. Before we get started, don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. It really helps me out as a small creator. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a new video and you can interact with me on the community tab. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so I have everything written down on a piece of paper because I wanted to make sure I didn't miss anything. I put a lot of work this year into figuring out what I really wanted to change about 2020. So after really reflecting on 2020 and where I think I could have lived a more fulfilled life, I came on my New Year's intention, which is to prioritize my health. Now I call this a New Year's intention instead of a New Year's resolution or a New Year's goal because it's truly getting at the very core of what I'm trying to do. So in that, I'm trying to actually go to all my doctor's appointments. I haven't been to a dentist since I was in college because I'm terrified of the dentist and I know that's bad for me. I want to actually exercise and eat healthy and fuel my body and get it moving, which might result in losing weight, but the reason I want to do that is so that I can prioritize my health. I want to stop drinking. It's just a personal thing of mine. I love a glass of wine here and there, but I just want to see what my life is like without it. So all of this revolves around the central theme of prioritizing my health, which I'm really excited to do in 2021, and I've actually started doing already. I'm gonna do a whole video on my fitness journey once my journey is actually complete. But again, it's never really complete, it's an ongoing thing, but I'm really excited to make some lifestyle changes and just feel more comfortable in my skin and know that I'm in the best possible health that I can be. Another top goal of mine is to organize my space and my life. Part of this is getting better at time management and actually organizing my day and fitting in things like exercising and going to doctor's appointments and not just working 24/7. But it also means organizing my space. I've been working with this organizing company called Life Simply Organized in Raleigh, North Carolina, and they are amazing. They've organized my closet and my office, and hopefully they have time to come back and do my filming room and my bathroom, and I'll actually be taking y'all along for that. But I just feel so much calmer and more at ease when I don't just have so much clutter in front of me. And I think organizing my life and my space and sort of getting things in order will help my mental health and kind of, again, help to prioritize my health, which is the main goal of 2021. My next resolution is to buy less things. This is really hard since on YouTube, a lot of what I do is reviewing new products, showing off new clothes, but I've just gotten to the point of consumption where it doesn't feel sustainable. I feel like I'm buying too much. I don't think it's good for the environment, for my bank account. So I want to buy things at a higher quality that I can really look forward to and know that I'm going to use for a long time. But don't worry, I still have some awesome things in the pipeline. I'll just be buying less things and buying more exciting things. My final two, and I would call these more goals, not resolutions, because they're less big and they're more focused. So the two are, I want to post more consistently, both on YouTube and Instagram. So in the past, I've uploaded twice a week, Mondays and Thursdays, and it was just exhausting. I might miss a day, end up leaving YouTube for like weeks or who knows how long, come back, try and sustain the old schedule, and it was so hard because I work a full-time job and I'm trying to do YouTube. So this year, I'm prioritizing posting consistently instead of posting more. So this means only posting once a week, but hopefully it means the videos are going to be higher quality, better thought out, and I won't be skipping weeks. And if I really get excited, I might do an extra video here and there, especially vlogs. I love just sprinkling those in. And then I also want to post more consistently on Instagram. If you haven't followed me, it's @Nicole_Huseman. I love Instagram, I love photography, but sometimes I get really nervous taking photos of myself because I love to be the one behind the camera. So I want to post more consistently throughout my life so that I'm documenting more of the important things. And finally, my last goal is that I want to hit 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. I am manifesting it and actually announcing it. I wasn't sure if I was going to tell y'all about this one, but if I put it out there, I have someone to hold myself accountable to. So I actually managed to get 3,000 subscribers, which blows my mind. I think it was January 2nd. And my goal for 2020 was to get 1,000. So I blew that one out of the water. So this year I'm going big. 10,000. That is my goal by the end of the year. And hopefully, you know, if you haven't subscribed already, you can hit that subscribe button and help me get towards my goal. But I am just so excited to see so much growth in this channel. 2020 was huge for me. I went from barely uploading to kind of uploading my first really sit down planned video instead of just like a one-off here and there. And it's been really fun. I transformed a room in my house into just a filming room, which is crazy. I have like a dedicated filming space. And I've just had so much fun chatting with y'all, hanging out with y'all, getting to know other YouTubers and other people on the internet. So hopefully 2021 is better than 2020. But truthfully, I really enjoyed 2020. There were a lot of lessons I learned from it. And I'm so, so thankful for my health, for the health of the people around me, for food and a roof over my head. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon so you get notified every time I upload a new video, which is every Thursday. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.